Hello guys, I am Pindra Badal. You are watching my YouTube channel LCS. As you have learned in my previous video related to some maintenance topic as well as the extreme programming. But at morning when I was reading a newspaper, that I seen that now onwards from first semester to the seventh semester exam will arrange on online, right? So it's a based on the MCQ. So I thought that I help to you to get the good marks in the first online exam, which is conducted by GTU, Gujarat Technological University. So I think I will prepare some MCQ question, part 1, part 2, part 3 in the subject of the software engineering, as well as I have put some question with the answer, so you can easily refer that, right? So without wasting my time, today we will start our session. And one more thing I tell you, if you have not subscribed my channel, please click on the subscribe button, so you will easily get this kind of the video from the my channel. So first question is, what are the characteristics of the software? So there are three characteristics. The software is developed or engineered, it is not manufactured in the classical sense. Second one is, the software doesn't wear out. Software can be custom built or custom made. So this three characteristics we have already learned. So the answer is D, all mentioned above. The second question is, compiler editor software come under which type of software? So that is a system software. Then third question is, software engineering is defined as a systematic discipline and quantifiable approach for the development, operation and maintenance of software. It is true or false? So yes, we are using the software engineering to develop the particular software in very perfect manner. So if we have do this kind of the step by step process, so at the end of we are getting the good product in terms of the software of the or the website. Fourth question is, RAID software process model stand for? It is the rapid application development, right? So in this video I have explained the many question, so I just go through the each slide. So you whenever you can start the read this kind of the question, just pause on the video and just read the all the option, right? So you can easily understand what actually answer is, because here I have written the answer, right? But whenever you are facing this question, so at that time possible they have changed the order of the answer, so you will stuck and you lose your marks as well. This is the fifth question. Software product management comprise of a number of activity which contains project planning, scope management and project estimation. So answer is D, because the software project management we are using the all three things, project planning, scope management and project estimation. COCOMO stand for? So it is, the answer is constructive cost model. Which of the following is not defined in a good software requirement specification document? So the answer is algorithm for software implementation, because we cannot easily write the algorithm for this software development. We have to just put the diagram of the algorithm. We cannot write the any SRS, right? What is the simplest model of the software development? As you know, waterfall model or linear model is a simple model for the software development. Which design identifies the software as a system with many components interact with each other? So architectural design, because whenever we have to interact with the different hardware or the software, we have to design architectural view of particular that system, so we can easily work on them. Also we can get the information from the different devices. 10. Which defect amplification model is used to illustrate the generation and detection of error during the preliminary step of software engineering process? So design, detailed design and coding, so we can easily get the error from the our process. Which method is used for evaluating the expression that passes the function as an argument? So strict evaluation. Which factor affect the probable consequences if a risk occurs? So in last video I have explained the different risk management or the type of the risk. So you can refer that video so you can easily understand this question and easily you can give answer of this kind of the question. Staff turnover, poor communication with the customer are risks that extrapolated from past experience are called predictable risk. Because it is possible whenever we are doing any project that this, in meanwhile the, some employees are leave the job and join the other companies, right? So that is the predictable risk. Which project is undertaken as a consequence of specific customer request? So new application development project. Software safety is a quality assurance activity that focus on hazard that may cause an entire system to fall. So true. Disadvantage of modularization. So smaller component are not easier to maintain. Program can be divided based on the functional aspect. Desired level of abstraction can be brought in the program. So this all above is the disadvantage of the modularization. Effective software project management focus on the 4 P's. What are those 4 P's? So people, product, process and project. Mention any 2 indirect measure of the product. So quality, efficiency and accuracy. So both A and B, both are the measure of the product, because we have to maintain the quality as well as the efficiency of the particular software or the web application. Which testing is the re-execution of some subset of tests that have already been conducted to ensure the changes that are not propagated? So regression testing, right? Because whenever we have developed once our any software, then we have made any change, so we have to do regression testing. Means again we have to testing of with the new functionality. Because as you know, unit testing means module testing, integration means different module we can integrate with it, then we do the integration testing. And thread based testing means that is the multiple project process or the transaction we are doing on the same application, at that time we are performing the thread based testing. So in this video I have explained around the 20 questions in subject of the software engineering. Also I will upload the next software engineering question as well as the answer, means part 2 and part 3. But if you are not satisfied with this video and you need a more video related to this kind of the question, so feel free write in the comment box, because during the lockdown I am available for you. So my wishes is that to you can get the maximum mark in the MCQ online exam, so you will get the good marks in your final year exam, final exam. And one more thing, if you have a doubt in any other subject, so you can also write in the comment box, I need this subject's MCQ question, so I definitely prepare for you and share with you, right? So please stay with my channel and don't forget to click on the subscribe and like button. If you have any question, you can also send me on my personal email address lcs.abp@gmail.com. And also I request to all of you, don't forget to share this video with your friends, because all students have to give the MCQ exam, so they can also get the benefit from this kind of the video. And frequently now onwards, every day I upload 3 to 4 video related to MCQ question, in particular these software engineering and other subjects. So you will easily get the
knowledge, how to ask the question in the exam, and you are not aware about the MCQ exam pattern, right? So you can easily learn that pattern from my video. Thank you.